parabolas, it's concerning the opposite way.
Mm-hmm.
So the vertices will be here, right here on the x-axis, and the focus are always inside, you know, the turning. Okay, so F1 is here, F2 is here. At any point on that hyperbola, if I give a distance F1P and I subtract that distance F2P, it's always also a constant, positive 2A or minus 2A. Okay, so that's how you draw a hyperbola. Now this is the equation. Very similar to the ellipse, but what happened? You have her.
They're squared.
Minus.
Okay. So here, it's x squared over a squared minus y squared over b squared equals 1. And this is going to be all about the x now.
Okay.
So that's the hyperbola that looks like this. This one and this one. Okay. The vertices, the foci are all on the f-axis. And here, is A bigger than B? I don't really care. You know, A can be bigger than B, B can be bigger than A. And then C squared is just the addition of those two. Yes?
Is a hyperbola like an ellipse except with the openings flipped?
Okay. It's like an ellipse that you cut in half. And then
you flip them open.
So, but for this we have what we call asymptotes, okay? And asymptotes here would be plus or minus b over a x. And then I know it's complicated. Why is it b over a?
Remember, slope is rise over run.
Mm-hmm.
Rise is under the y, run is under the x.
So you rise x, y value, you run x value.
So b over a. So this would be what I call the flat hyperbola,
kind of, you know.
And then if I have x squared over a squared, oh, sorry, y squared over a squared minus x squared over b squared equals 1. This is the long one now, but kind of. This one goes this way and that way. So it's all about the y now.
A is always going to be in the first term?
No.
No?
A is always going to be on the first term for a hyperbola. The A and B, you see, don't switch places.
Uh-huh.
But the x and y switch places.
Okay.
So for the hyperbola, I don't care where A is, I don't care where B is. Okay. A is always first, B is always second. That's given. But for the hyperbola, all about the x, x is first, as you can see. All about the y is first.
That's it. That's how you make the difference. Okay.
It's not about A bigger or A smaller.
A could be bigger or smaller, but we don't care.
A is the first, B is the second. That's it. And of course, what is the equation of the asymptotes here? Y would be plus or minus rise over run. Okay, A would be there. They switch. Okay. Here the vertices are 0 plus or minus A. The focus are 0 plus or minus C. Here the vertices are plus or minus A, 0, and the focus plus or minus C, 0. And so you switch that. And that's it.
Okay, so I think I have two examples here again.
Okay, same thing, the distance between the two foci is 2C, between the two vertices is 2A, center is vertex A, center is vertex C.
So same thing as A is. Okay, we have the same property.
It says find vertices, foci, asymptote, and sketch.
Y squared minus x squared equals 4. What should I do first?
Divide by 4.
Divide by 4. So y squared minus x squared equals 4. Divide by 4, we get y squared over 4 minus x squared over 4 equals 1.
This is a hyperbola. What is A?
Two.
B is?
Two.
And C is?
Zero.
Mm.
Two and two.
No.
Nope.
Now you're adding?
Eight. Yeah. This is where you add now, okay? So that's two and two, yeah. So the other one you're subtracting, this one you add. So where are the vertices?
y that front is all about the y. Right?
0 plus or minus 2.
Y, yeah.
And 0 plus or minus 2 root 2. The y is first, it's all about the y. Okay? And what is the asymptotes? What are the asymptotes? Y equals plus or minus.
Oh,
well, a and b are the same, so it doesn't really matter.
So it's just 1 plus minus x.
Plus or minus x.
Had it.
And then you draw. So when you draw, you need to put the vertices, the foci, and the asymptotes. Okay? The vertices are 0 plus or minus 2, so 1, 2 here. The other one, right here. Okay, and then the foci, 2, root 2, which is about 3.7? Oh no, 2.8, sorry, 2.8. If this is 3, 2.8 is somewhere here. So vertex 1, focus 1, vertex 2, and this is 3, focus 2 would be here. Now to draw the asymptotes correctly, we can find the turning points, which are 2, 0, okay, and minus 2, 0, that's the B. This gives you the turning points. Well, it's not turning points really, but... So right here, I put 2, 0, and minus 2, 0. Then you can make a box here. If you make a box from the vertex to that turning, kind of. Then the diagonal of that box are your asymptotes. So one asymptote here, and the other one is here. And notice that the slope is 1 and minus 1. So you see, rise. And then to draw, you start here. From the vertex, you go, and you want to touch that asymptote, but you don't touch it. And you go this way. And same thing, you start here, and you go along the asymptote.